Andrew Perry, and this is the Desert Dogs. In this episode of the Desert Dogs, we are visiting Fossil Falls, which is right next to a dry lake. This entire area is a humongous archaeological site. There are chippings all over the ground and rock art all over the canyons over here. And I hear the coyote. The entire area has been shaped by volcanic activity, dating back as far as 400,000 years. The large red cinder cone that is visible to the north of Fossil Falls is the most recent volcano and last erupted approximately 10,000 years ago.
Oh, this fire is doing it to me.
Well, we could probably just stand in here. A lot better. But I think it's burning my leg hairs.
Is that wormwood?
No, but there was worms in the wood at a point. These little tracks here that you can see, these are called insect larvae galleries. It's probably from the larvae of some kind of beetle that laid its eggs in between the bark and the meat of the tree. And what it would do as it develops is it would eat its way through that middle portion until it gained enough energy to become an adult. Or it would probably emerge.
Cool.
Somewhere.
Before everyone woke up, I thought I'd take a little stroll with my dog, Boo Bear. By the way, I'm not the one who named her. My wife did. In this clip, I'm giving my interpretation of the petroglyph, but the wind was so strong it ruined the audio. I basically said that there is a petroglyph portraying a shaman with 5 mountain sheep, and maybe he was trying to summon some mountain sheep. For the most part, petroglyphs are extremely difficult to interpret, since we are separated by a gulf of time, sometimes as much as 10,000 years or more. After all, there is evidence that Native Americans have inhabited this region as much as 20,000 years ago, when this area was much greener and plant life and animal life was much more abundant. But by 6000 BCE, these first inhabitants were forced by an increasingly harsh climate to abandon the area. 2000 years later, 4000 BCE, Native Americans returned to the area after the climate became more moderate. These Indian tribes had an entirely different culture and had new practices centered on gathering resources in a desert climate. These people survived until the 19th century when the tribe known as the Little Lake Shoshone first made contact with Europeans. Again, another shot ruined by the wind. I'm talking about the foundations of what was probably a dwelling. The people that lived here long ago probably had shelters that were covered with tule and grasses. After some hiking around, Boo and I decided to walk back to camp, and I find that the camp is beginning to bustle with activity. It isn't long until we all decide to hike the short distance to Fossil Falls.
About this area is that petroglyphs for mountain sheep is not so much for, you know, good hunting type thing. It's more for, I believe, rain. The shaman, mountain sheep shamans, but you know, you just never know.
Fossil Falls is an ancient waterfall that was sculpted sometime during the last glacial period, when volcanic activity caused the Owens River to change course and run along the basalt volcanic rock that is the dominant feature of the landscape. This was about 10 to 15,000 years ago.
Yay! Hello? That's pretty
neat. After hiking past the falls, Joe Perry decides to check out an archaeological site called the Skull Site, which is just a little further. The Skull Site is ancient, and probably one of the most ancient sites there are in the United States, dating back to more than 10,000 years. While most of the artifacts have been removed from previous archaeological digs, the Skull Site is definitely an amazing thing to come across. To think that people were camped alongside a river here more than 10,000 years ago is a humbling thought to someone who is only familiar with 30 years of existence.
Back when they were living here, there were some fairly large trees growing along the creek. And so this site right here, last I heard, was the oldest house village complex that's discovered so far.
An explanation on that?
Probably was making a knife or a point, and he was working it and it broke in half and he went, oh! And it broke.
How about that one?
Well, it could be a scraper. There's some, a lot of these things are tools. So if you see a fine edge that's been down there, it looks like this has had work, you know, been used. You know, it could be, you know, like the shave, you know, like wood and stuff like that. It's okay to pick this stuff up and you know, look at it or see where it was, pick it up and look at it, you know, but put it back where it was.
While we were here, a man drove by with a bulldozer and told us to get off private property. Joe disputed him on whether the area was private property, because there were no signs indicating it. Joe thought that this was BLM land.
They look pretty bloody, so they probably got shot.
We noticed in the bed of the bulldozer's blade that there were about 20 dead ducks inside it. The man said he'd call the police and went on his way. He dumped the ducks in a pile of rocks not too far from where we were standing, probably so the coyotes can have some food. After checking out the ducks, we decided to head back, as we wanted to respect private property, even though we were still skeptical about the old man's claim. In the next episode, the desert dogs make a trip to the El Paso wilderness and get ideas for a trip that might even surpass, in difficulty at least, the Panamint City trek we did in April of 2008. This is Andrew Perry. Let's try and keep a reasonable guess.
There's nothing wrong with the dust. I'm doing perfect.